Hey guys, so I'm going to show you how to make chicken salad. So I've already done this, but I cooked like three decent sized pieces of chicken. And when you're cooking it, like for me, mine were still frozen. So I put them in the oven at 450 for about half an hour just to thaw them out, and then for an hour, they were at like 360. And then halfway through the hour, I flipped them. Also, I put water on the bottom of the pan so the moisture stays in the chicken. So let's get started. Okay, so you're gonna need chicken. What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take off this kind of paper-like skin that has developed. And so I'm gonna angle the camera, and here we go. Hopefully you can see it. I'm gonna try my best here. Sorry, I'm trying to see without the. Don't have to do this, but I'm going to. Because depending if you overcooked your chicken or not, like this is, you'll be able to eat this, but if some of you overcook it or something, it's not going to be good. Yeah, that's probably about all I'm about to get off of that one. Just going to do the other one real quick. Just pulled the bone out of that. That's some good chicken on there. Okay, there's not much skin to peel off that one. So, pretty much I've taken off all of the skin, and where I couldn't get it off, that's probably a little too crunchy or has cartilage or something on it. So now you want to get it off the bone. It's probably better if I didn't have it with the bone, so boneless chicken would be great. Now I'm just gonna peel it off first. That way you can feel for like the little bones. Has a really nice color to it. I'm just putting it in a pile. And yes, you're gonna get messy, so. Probably best if I didn't do this on a dinner plate, but oh well. Decent for that one. Do this other big piece. The bigger pieces are probably a lot easier. Make sure you wash your hands before breaking this apart. You don't want to. And always remember when you're going to cook the chicken after you have put it on the pan that you're going to cook it in, wash your hands afterwards. It's important that you don't cause cross contamination, because then you're going to get sick and it's really disgusting. Trust me, food poisoning is no joke. It is the most vile thing ever. Because for some people, it lasts longer. You can have it up to like a week. Okay, I'm not gonna get much meat off of this one. No. Okay, so now I'm just gonna separate the meat. Okay, so I just grabbed a pan and a bowl. You'll see where it comes in handy. Now, I'm gonna start cutting the bits of chicken, the bits of chicken that I took off the bone. I'm just gonna start cutting them into like more decent sizes, like smaller sizes, because even in chicken salad, you don't get like huge chunks, so. So after you're done cooking the chicken, you want to let it cool in the fridge for about 2 hours. So you can go in and check on it and see when it's cooler. For me, it took roughly 2 hours. Probably better to tear it up with my hands, but of course I'm not doing that. Because if you do get some that has like still skin on it, it'll like stay attached. Let's pull that apart. For some of the pieces, I'm gonna have to just pull it. Just tearing it up right now because the knife wasn't working so well with some of it. You just want to shred it. You don't want it too small, but yet you don't want it too big where someone could choke on something. And your hands do get kind of slippery with all the moisture from cooking it. Okay, so when you pick out celery, you want to make sure it's nice and green. And make sure there's like nice leaves are not dead and everything. You can cut off this part or break it off. And I usually cut off the top here because there's really no use for actually easy enough where you can just break it off. What I usually do is I slice. And this, for some reason, does not want to slice correctly down the middle. But you slice down the middle and you chop away, like so. Okay, I'll do the smaller piece. Now you don't have to do a fancy chef way. I'm not. It's just to avoid cutting my fingers off. Because knowing me, that would probably happen. And just make them into smaller pieces. That's just fairly important. So I'm just gonna chop it like crazy. And then you can just put it in a pile and then just put your hand over it and like go down on it. I'm not cutting on the best surface. I'm using actually a pan because I have no clue where my cutting board is. So. I gotta bring these over here. I feel like this knife is dull, so I'm not getting the best cutting I should be. Not a lot of people probably like celery, so. I'm not gonna need too much celery for this. At least I don't think. The thicker part of the celery is gonna be harder to cut. And depending on you've got an even cut. The first place. Okay, for some reason my video cut out, but I chopped up some celery. Make sure you clean the celery before you use it. But you want to make small pieces, and I might continue chopping, and I'll see you in a little bit. Okay, hey guys, so this is the celery I cut up. I only cut out, I think, two stalks so far. So what I'm gonna do. We're just gonna mix it in here to see how the ratio is because there is a lot of chicken, and I want to make sure before I start mixing stuff. put the other stuff in. So I'm just gonna be messy. You can use a spoon if you want, but it's always best to work with your hands. Yeah, I think this is the right amount. Ooh, I'm losing chicken. So let me go rinse. Now, if you want to, you can add like a half a cup of almonds, but I didn't. Plus, I didn't have any almonds around. Also, you can lightly marinate this with French dressing. So, next step is to add this lovely. I know it looks gross. mayonnaise to the mix. 1 cup. That's what I have here. And yeah. So let's do this. This should be interesting. This is gonna get messy, and I should have just thrown it in the other. That's why I brought the pot over. Clearly, I wasn't thinking. Well. Okay, so what I'm gonna do, since I totally didn't do this, here's the pot so you can stir it in. Doesn't just mean ultimately store it in that. Okay, so there we go. Just mix it in there. I'm just mixing it with a regular spoon because I am awesome like that. I think that's pretty well mixed. So, I just grabbed another spoon. You can taste it and find out what you need to do to it. Not bad. I'll put that one. It says you can add salt or paprika. This is what paprika looks like. And for like a this size container, oh gosh. Paprika, depending on the size of the container, can run from anywhere from like $4 to like 10, 15, depending on the size and what type, because there's gourmet and crap like that. So I'm just gonna put up. No, I'm not gonna make that side. Just gonna slip down. Okay. Sorry, now I'm like, oh, whatever. So you can see what I'm doing. Just take a pinch of it. Not too much. You never want to do too much salt. As if you all don't know, especially in older people and elderly people, salt. Older people retain salt, so your legs, they kind of fill up with water in a sense. It doesn't happen to young people because they can regulate the levels, but also salt isn't the greatest thing for you, but oh well, it makes everything good. And if you do this little tradition thing, you just throw salt out of your shoulder. I just do it. I don't know why. I just do if you're superstitious like that. Okay. And you don't want to do too much paprika. Just enough. Okay. Then just mix it all together. And then I can determine what it needs from there. Probably would have been even better if I could get the chunks even, the celery some more. Not going to do that because I need my. That's actually not bad. can always add some more mayonnaise if that's to your liking of having it more moist. But here is our chicken salad. I know it's not very presentable, but that's what it is. I'm trying to get a good view of it, but if I have to, I'll take a picture. But and that took me maybe a half an hour to mix it all together because you had to do all the chopping unless you prepare your main stuff while the chicken's cooking or cooling. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video. I know I did. I'm gonna go because it's getting late, so if you have any other ideas that you want me to try, yeah, I'll try cooking something else or researching stuff for you. But let me know, comment, subscribe, like, tell your friends to check out the channel and subscribe as well. And I should be back within the next couple days or next week with a new video. Bye, guys. I have a lot of editing ahead of me, so yay. All right, bye.